distinctively different. When you bring in my androgyny, you're trying to make us the same, but we're not. And that's the essence of Satan's desire, is to try and make us equal, because that goes against the divine patriarchy that the Most High set up in this earth. You cannot collapse this distinction without further collapsing all other distinctions that depend upon it. I digress. That's what I'm saying. We're not the same.
That's understood. I would like to say that sex is the joining of two energies to create another one. And that's the essence of how we all got here. I'm not trying to be in opposition to anything that you're saying relative to, you know, your perspective. What I'm saying is, internally, do you feel the nurturing
essence? It's not a perspective, it's a truth. So you go out, okay, you get pregnant, you go out, and then you get pregnant by another man. That's a distinction that we have that you don't have, but you're still missing it. I could go out and have sex with a woman a couple hours from now, have sex a couple hours later, and then again tonight, and get all three pregnant. You do that. That's a distinction. That's not an equality. That's a power that man has that you don't have. That's a distinction that the Most High created for a reason.
I'm not in opposition to that. And I'm not saying that we're equal. What I'm saying is, relative to what
you're saying. When you talk androgyny, that's exactly what you're saying. Because androgyny, it says we're both, and if you go back to the conversation, you said it. You're always talking about the male and the female that's in both of us. But when a male is in his Most High divine proper space, he's more masculine, and he's supposed to be more masculine than he is feminine. When a man's femininity overtakes his masculinity, you got a bitch. And you get what you get in society right now. You got women coming on like you that think you could be equivalent to a man when you're not. And the first damn thing will happen, if something get physical, you'll have to call another man to protect you. Or you're going to have to use a weapon or something that was created by a man. There's no equality here. People don't want to hear conversations like this, but they need to hear it, because you're not my equal. You're not my equal. You're not. We're not designed the same way. I'm designed a degree above you. I could do things that you can't do. Sure, you could do some things that I can't do, but I most likely wouldn't want to do those. I create things for you to live in. We create houses. We create the buildings. We create the internet. We create the weapons. You can't live without a man, but we can live without you until we're dead.
Stop letting them increase your rates. I used to let them raise my car insurance every year until I found this.
But we need each other to reproduce, but stop trying to make yourself my equal, because you're not. You're not. You couldn't survive without me. If you snatch away all the things that I, man, have created, women wouldn't be able to survive. It's been proven that they can't survive out on their own. They can't do it. You look at my almost all the inventions in the world was created by men. We're creators. The Most High put that in us. And it's time that the world acknowledge that and recognize it, because that's the truth. That's the way it is. Most of what you've learned, you know what this philosophy you're coming from? You learned it from a man. You heard it from some woman. Even if you heard it from a woman, she got that from a man. Your universities and all of this created by men. They put women in them, but they was created by men, because men are the creators.
Well, I appreciate you for creating the platform, because this is a topic that needs to be discussed a little further without us having to devalue each other, because I'm not looking to be equal to anybody in particular. What I am looking to do is get to the truth of things. And it seems like in most of the doctrines that we do find, it's very little essence of the truth in it. It's always something that serves one person over another, and everybody else is just kind of left to the wolves. And it really seems that way as I'm looking at things.
Let's forget doctrines for a second, right? Just you and I, right? Just you and I. No, we're not dealing with the Bible. We're not dealing with nothing. Let's deal with truths. Let's deal with truths. All right. the house that you're living in, did an architect group of women get together and build that and build this? No, it was men. If you see a woman architect, where did she learn that from? She learned it from men. She learned that from men. These are facts. So in order for her to learn that, she had to learn that from a man. It was a man that was out there. You could go back to prehistoric times, man. Men back there in the so-called stone ages building stuff, carving things, making places for you to live in. Men was the protectors. Men was putting their lives on line, building spears and all of that to protect their women and children. Men did that. And it's been that way from the beginning. And you women need to learn to respect men. You need to start showing some damn appreciation, because you're disrespectful. You're not my equal. You couldn't even survive without us. That's a reality. You're not supposed to talk like this, but the hell was politically correct. The truth is more important, and the truth doesn't need any apology. None of you women can survive without us. Without the things that men have produced in this world, you wouldn't be able to survive. And that's a fact. That's indisputable. Any woman, I don't care what position she's in, she's ascertained that position because a man allowed it. Because men run the world, and men go to war to conquer other men. And so the only reason that women have placed within these paradigms is because men allowed it. That's why you become spoils of war when one nation conquers another. You get raped or taken over, and the man decides he's going to do what the hell he want to do with you. And it's time that you women realize that, man. That's a fact. These are facts. Now, that's not dealing with religion or nothing. It's dealing with truth, man. That's pure truth right there. Now, if you want help, you got to call a man. You got to call a man.
I particularly wouldn't, but is that why the country is like it is now? Because it seems like, I don't know, I don't even know how to address
it. Don't like it, leave. See, I'm tired of that excuse right there, too. You wouldn't be able to produce the country like it is now. That's a fact. You wouldn't be able to build a damn thing because you would have done it. When you go to college and get these edumacations, let me ask you this. The first... Who started the first university? Was it a woman or a man?
I don't know, but they probably didn't go to a university.
It was a man.
He didn't go to a university.
Yeah, he created it. I said who started it. Of course he didn't go.
Did you see what they look like now, though?
He created it.
The medical community. These people are learning what these people are teaching them, but they're not experiencing it in their real life. So then we have people creating vaccines.
Started by men. I will even go back and take you and educate you on that the first cooks were men. Men taught you to cook. How about that? Men taught you to cook. There's very few that you say you could actually do that a man didn't teach you or someone down your lineage. Men did it.
And women
acknowledge that, and I take that as highly disrespectful because I'm a masculine dude. And I'm tired of women walking around like, you know what I mean? It don't stink or whatever. Well, everything that you're just about using on a daily basis was created by man.
This is the stuff your insurance company doesn't want you to know about. Have you noticed your auto insurance?
And I appreciate it. If you appreciate it,
you will humble yourself and acknowledge it and stop trying to make yourself our equal. Because the fact is, if all men left, and they just took those women that wanted to be submissive and like real women, you guys would just perish. You guys would just perish. All you women that want to be masculine and all of that, you would perish. You wouldn't be able to survive. That's a fact. When that generation die off, you guys would be done because you wouldn't have anyone building or none of that. All men gone. You live in a society by yourself. You go over there, you build that. You live off for that.
Well, I am thankful for the men. It does add the.
No, you're not. If you was, then women would show more appreciation. She wouldn't be keep trying. See, she think it's a war. When a man said he wants to be in his rightful place, like, listen, man, I'm the man. Listen, a man was created to be a head. The woman is part of the body. Am I saying that man should function without her? No. I'm saying she's not his equal. The man is the head. That's the way that the Most High made it. He's the head. She's part of the body. Without a head, you can't properly call a body into order. These are the facts, man. So this is why men have capacity to do many things that Eve may not be able to do. A man's strength is that way for a reason. A man can reproduce like that for a reason.
Okay. Am I to understand that this is not a personal attack on me? Because I am one woman. Like, I'm not, and I'm not coming at,
I'm talking to women in general. Talking to you. I'm talking to, but the mindset of the modern woman is like yours. So I'm talking to each and every woman out there that has that particular mindset. Because that's the vast majority of women. Why do you think right now, I just stated, by 2030, 45% of women is going to be single with no children. What good is she in society? She's supposed to be an incubator for a man. The woman don't even understand her purpose of creation on this earth. You don't naturally have a purpose on this earth. You're going for what the world teaches you. Your primary purpose on this earth was to help the man, to be his incubator, to be his helpmeet. He reproduces life through you. That was your primary function and purpose on this earth. This world has moved away from it, and that's why the world is so messed up. People don't want to hear that, but that's the creator's design. And when you go against that design, you get the chaos. Don't blame it on men. Blame it on you for not wanting to play your part. Blame it on the evil patriarchals that's under Satan's authority that put women like you and other women out there in combat against her man. And she think is right, but more and more, you're seeing single women destroying children, rearing them alone and destroying them. Destroying them. They're destroyed. Look at the violence. Look at the mindset. Look, you know what they don't like to say in society? It's been proven that children that's raised by both parents do much better than children raised by a single woman. You can look these up yourself all over. Statistics show it. But you know what they don't push? Is that children that's raised by a single father do equally as good as children raised by both parents. Explain that one, sis. Explain that one.
The competence level of a lot of people in society would explain that, like, relatively. But what I'm trying to consider, when I came on here, I came on here to support you. As a man, not my man, but as a man, because I see what you're doing and the work is phenomenal. So for me personally, you know, relative to you, I did come just like when we talked, what I was talking about with your book. I didn't say, hey, pay me to do the forward to your book. And then I said, well, are you going to use it? You said, of course, you wrote it. Why wouldn't I? But you don't even remember me. And so I'm like, well, maybe women aren't that important to you, but relative to the children.
Oh, see? Yeah, y'all caught that, huh? Y'all caught that, huh? Now women are not important to me because...
I'm not saying that they're not, but like...
You know what I'm speaking?
That concept. Like, you don't even remember who I am, but I wrote the 4G book.
Yes, and that was years ago. Marty, how you had Matt Too Saucy? Universal, you caught that? You caught that, Matt Too Saucy?
Yeah.
Let me make this very clear, Secret Balance. I love women.
Hold on to your wig. You won't believe this nonsense. Have y'all seen the $5,800 health aid?
I love real women. I love... See, here's the thing about me. I'm a spiritual man. I love women that are submissive women. A woman that's going to stand by me and be the woman of the Most High. I'll die for that woman. Because that's my purpose of being here. I'll readily die for a woman that's going to stand by me and play her role like she was designed to be, to do, and my children. I'll lay my life down for that with no problem. But the thing that I see now, that's Satan's woman. I wouldn't die for her. I wouldn't even marry her. I wouldn't even trust her because she's not herself anymore. That's fallen woman. That's fallen woman. And so, I mean, you see how you say you was for me? I listen to what people say. I don't just have foresight. I have insight. So I'm able to look into what people are really saying and get the, you know, the true meaning of what they're really saying. So while you say, well, you're for me, but you say, I don't like women, which is a lie. Listen, man, there's not a brother on this call that would not be attracted to a feminine, submissive woman. There's something about a feminine, submissive woman that a masculine man can't resist. It is in his nature to love that kind of woman. And women don't get that. That's all I'm really trying to say. But the women are so masculine, you can't talk to them like this. Because they take it as something weak. Huh? But when a woman comes on very masculine, and you keep emphasizing about your shoulders, well, it's masculine. It's a turnoff for masculine men. The polarities are off. In order for the polarities are on, if the man is masculine, then the more feminine the woman is, the better that relationship works out. The reason that relationships are not working in society, Eve is running her mouth. She's trying to be masculine. Like she's trying to drive a point home. Then when a man says, you know what? I'm done. She'll go and get a divorce, but the guy's done. And so sometimes the man doesn't want to deal with her so much. You know, a lot of fathers don't deal with their children because they don't want to deal with you. He don't want to deal with you. He goes through all types of intense pain to stay the hell away from you. So he stay away from his children. He said, I'll deal with them when they get older. And none of you could understand that because you're not in the position of a man. So the man said, okay, you want to raise him? You raise him. Because the rightful thing to do was to let them go with their father. Now, if you really love those children, it's been proven over again, over and over and over again, that the father is the most essential element in those children's life in the event of like a separation. The mother could be gone. The father will usually get another woman that could play that role of a mother. The same is not true. She'll get some man that's abusive. He might be a predator and so on and so forth. So the children develop all these problems, or she doesn't get a man at all. She's working all of the time. The children are rearing themselves. So we have, I could use the so-called black community as a catalyst. 80% of the children in the black community are raised by a single parent, the so-called black woman, Miss Know-It-All, right? That got it all together, but she's ruining the children's lives and then blame the man. Oftentimes these fathers want to be in their life. She won't let him. The court system works with her because they want to destroy it. They want to destroy that family. So she goes and get on these whatever benefits, and the children suffer. And she tells the children's father, I mean the children, how no good their father are and how he abandoned them. But there's always two sides to every story. And so statistically it's been proven that the so-called black men that they desecrate more than anyone, he spends more time with his children than any other man on the planet. But they don't tell that side of the story. They don't tell that side of the story. That inclusive of Europeans, the so-called black man spent more time with his children. So it's not about an attack on you. It's about men returning to being men and women returning to being women. And so this is why the so-called black community is so damn destroyed. The fathers are not in the homes. Gone. But you have to look into why. Did he just leave? I don't think he just left. There's a reason that he's gone. But the picture that they painted him, oh, this man's no good. He's horrific. He's accustomed to abandoning his family, his children. Yeah, but where did he learn that at? Now, I could say that's an institution that was built off of white supremacy, and now they're trying to hide it and say, oh, the so-called black man doesn't like his family. But you made him that way. You snatch families apart on the slave plantations. You put them on different, you snatch the family right away. And so you develop this thing that was nurtured into these men.
I want to enjoy my free time and not worry about expensive home repairs. So my friend recommended 210 Home.
For what? Over 300 years. And then say, why does he do that? Well, you engineered him to do that. But you don't want to assume responsibility. You see how that works? No one wants to talk about that.
Do you have a possible remedy for these things? Because I've experienced what you're speaking of.
I do. And you return to being a woman. You return to being submissive and a woman, which you don't want to do. But that's very hard for an androgynous sister like yourself. Both sexes, right? I mean, we both got the male and female. Yeah, we do. But the masculine man is going to always want that feminine woman. That's a woman that a man would die for. And women don't get that because they don't know how to be women anymore. Women haven't been taught. Women are not taught to be women. They want the bag. They want the bag. Well, see, and I can prove it. So a woman, when she's selecting a man, she's selecting a man based on, well, how much, what do you do for a living? Why is that one of the first questions? Man doesn't care about that. If he's well off, he doesn't care if you're working at McDonald's or not working at all. Why is it like that? See, she wants the benefits of a traditional woman, but she doesn't come as a traditional woman because a traditional woman had to be a virgin. That was a long time ago for most Eves. You see that? But she wants the benefits of the traditional woman.
So would me being a woman be to leave the platform? Because I'm like, I don't, like I'm lost for words here.
Oh, you what?
Okay.
Oh, you say you need to leave?
It's time for me to leave. Is this where I take my exit? Like, because I'm trying to see, like, you're not being a woman. So is that to not continue to speak on the issues that we're talking about? Or
You came to that analogy on your own. I can't recall saying secret balance, leave the platform. You must have established that analogy in secret.
No, I was asking a question because I was trying to see if we were in a open conversation or if I was getting attacked, because that's what it kind of felt like.
So for the third time, secret balance, you personalize it. And the question seemed as though it was rhetorical. Forgive me, sis. Forgive me. Forgive me, sis.
Well, I digress, and I will leave you all to your show. Thank you.
Shalom. So